My name is Lindsay Chichester. I'm the Douglas County Extension Educator, and with me today is Del Barber. He is a master beekeeper and he's also my mentor. So today we want to talk about apiary setup and design and things just to consider as you might be getting ready to set up some hives for yourself. So one of the first things we did is we came out to this area and determined a good location that we could set up a fence. Cleaned it with a rake, get out big sticks, rocks, and other debris. And then we actually set up a bear-proof fence. So since we're along a river corridor here, it is a bear-proof fence. We also put chicken wire on the ground at the advisement of the Nevada Department of Wildlife to assist in a just additional shock should a bear visit the apiary. And so Del will visit with you a little bit about how the hives are specifically laid out and things to consider.
Thank you. With this setup that Lindsay got started last year, she had pallets that she put down on the ground, and then she placed 8x16 cinder blocks on top of the pallet and raised it up so that the hive was sitting 16 inches a minimum above the ground. And the reason for that is that some animals, particularly skunks, like to come up and scratch on the front of the hive, and they'll just devour the bees as they come out. So by having it up off the ground by 16 inches, the skunk has to stand on its hind legs and expose its ventral surface, and the bees can sting it, so that discourages it. So that's one of the reasons we do this. Now, as far as any other design and equipment you need for this, you'll need a bottom board, and you can either get a solid bottom board or a screen bottom board. This happens to be a screen bottom board, and that allows mites that fall off the bees to drop all the way through the screen and be caught underneath. That way they're not on the bottom boards, the bees climb in and the mites can then get back on the bees. So it is an extra precaution for controlling the mites. Then on that bottom board, you're going to set your deep hive box. This has two deep, but you'll start, if you're going to start a hive, you'll start with one deep box. And inside of that box, depending on what size you get, you'll either have 8 frames or 10 frames. You get an 8-frame box, it's a little bit lighter because there are fewer frames. A 10-frame box is going to be a little heavier when it gets full of bees and honey. It's going to weigh about 80 pounds. So you want to make sure that you can handle that. So decide what you want to get there. But you should purchase two boxes to start with. You only put one box down to start your bees, and then you'll add the other box as the hive grows. On top of that box, you will put an inner cover, and then on top of that inner cover, you'll put your telescoping top piece. You'll see that Lindsay has her set up. She's gone through a winter, so she's got two deep boxes, and on top of it, she's got some frames that hold dry sugar or fondant. And she's got two of those on top of here. Then she's got her telescoping cover on top of that. Then, just to secure it, she's put cinder blocks, but she also has a strap, a nylon strap on there to keep it under control and hold the top down. She's also included, because it's starting to warm up a bit, to put a sunshade on the front of that hive. This happens to be a political sign. It's not as large as it should be for this hive, but it does allow shade to fall on the front of the hive. You'll notice that this hive is painted a light color, white with then some nice decorations on it. But the hive adjacent to it is painted green, a darker green. This hive gets really hot inside, and the bees beard on the outside, they're trying to cool it down. So you should always start with a light color, and then if you want to paint designs on it, that's fine. But go with white and then paint your designs on there. That pretty much takes care of the basic stuff that you need to buy when you're getting ready to set up a hive. Make sure that when you set up, she mentioned that she's raked this off and cleaned it off with rock, from the rocks and sticks and so forth. When you set it up, try to get that hive as level as you possibly can, both left and right, front and back. And there should be just a slight tilt to the front of the hive, and that will allow any rain that falls on the front board, the landing board, not to go back inside the hive. So get it level, with just a slight tilt to the front. A hive should always face south, southeast. And the reason for that, if the bees come out in the morning, they orient off the sun so that they can communicate with the other bees with their dance where the forage is for that morning. So make sure it's south, southeast. Any other angle, it's kind of confusing for the bees. They like that sun coming up and being able to orient off that sun.
So at this location for this apiary, we're out in the middle of a cattle pasture that's flood irrigated. So we've had to take all of that into consideration. And one of the things we've done or knew that we needed to do was to have an electric wire fence. And at this location, we specifically chose T-posts with the poly electric wire, just so that we can raise it up enough as the field is irrigated, the water doesn't have a problem or mess up any of our wire fencing. And so this space is actually a 20 by 25 rectangle, and we'll put about 4 hives out here. And what we also have, in addition to the wire, so the wires, there's 4 strands, and they're 10 inches apart, or 10 inches between each wire. And so that might just need to be modified based on the animals that you would try to keep out. At this location, cattle is our primary animal that we keep out. Bears potentially could be a problem. And if we think that's the case, we might go ahead and add a 5th wire and just tighten up that 10 inch space between the wires. Since this apiary location is in the middle of a pasture that will be flood irrigated, pallets won't work here, cinder blocks or other bricks will. But what we're going to do is all the hives will be up on stands. And you can see this one's got legs. And then I also have just some small bricks that I'm gonna put under here just to provide some extra support under it. And I'll put one under each of the legs so that when the water moves through here, it should stay and keep my hive wood nice and clean and from absorbing much of that moisture. So we've got 2 natural water resources here. We won't have to bring any water in or supply it. One that's to the south of where the bees will fly out, and one behind them to the north. The hive should face south to southeast. So as the sun rises in the morning, it kind of shines on their front entrance of the hive, wakes them up and orients them that another day has come. One of the great things about this location is the forage available to the bees. So there's a lot of dandelions right now, clover, red, white, and yellow, and there's also alfalfa in the area. So some great resources for the bees. One thing that this location does not have is a windbreak, since we are in the middle of a pasture. So we might have to control that at some point with some windscreen or tarps to help offset that if it becomes problematic. And another thing we don't have here is shade either. So we can artificially bring in some sort of shade structure, whether it be a tarp or campaign signs, something to offer a little bit of shade to the bees.